Hold up.
How deep can we go? Hello everyone. I'm back again in the same outfit because I always film 2 videos in a row just because you be efficient. But I'm sure you don't care. Anyways, I have had the iPad Pro now for a couple of months and I want to share my thoughts on it and tell you all about how which programs I'm using and how I'm using it and all of that good stuff. To start off with, I have the gold version, the 12.9, and I think that that's a really good size if you are actually going to be drawing on it. If you constantly have to zoom in on the 9 or the 10 inch one or whatever it is now, then I think it would be slightly irritating. But this is like a pretty good proper size of piece of paper, and I'm very pleased with that, the size. And it's beautiful, obviously, the equipment. I bought a nice case. I was looking for a case and, you know, I was thinking, oh, some of the cases are so expensive, like the actual Apple Smart Cover and stuff like that. But then when you're thinking about it, this is a machine. It cost me 12,000 kroner. Why am I whining about a case that's like $40, you know? So I got this case, I think it was 40 pounds from Pipetto London, and it is this beautiful blue color, and it's called their origami case because you can fold it slightly different. I don't know, whatever. It's a nice case. I am pleased. It's good quality, and I think it will hold for a long time. I also, to protect the screen and also to help with the drawing, I bought a paper-like, it's called that, the brand, paper-like screen protector, and it does actually feel like paper, and it's makes it slightly more matte, so it's not as shiny, and I like that. It does distort the beautiful screen quality slightly, but I think that that hardly matters, and I kind of like that it has like slight texture. It's still very clear, and it doesn't distort that much, but I primarily use this for drawing, so I think this is perfect. And everybody, I saw reviews online, and everybody thinks it's so difficult and impossible to apply a screen protector like this on the large size. But I found it really easy. I didn't have any problems with bubbles or dust or anything. But I followed the instructions, and I was very careful to do it properly and very slowly in a dust-free environment, aka the bathroom after a shower. So that worked out really well. And then of course we have the Apple Pencil. It's my last accessory, and you couldn't do anything without this. And I'm very pleased. It's very nice. The only thing I think that's ridiculous is that it charges in the iPad like this. We can also use the adapter and charge it regularly, which I haven't done, but that's the scariest thing when you have it like sticking out. I'm so afraid that it's gonna fall over, someone's gonna whack into it, especially my clumsy boyfriend, and just like break it, but trying to keep it out of the way and safe. So that's all the like first things I wanted to share about the iPad, I believe. Now let's just, let me get closer and I'll show you all of the programs and things that I've been using and loving. Alright, welcome to my iPad. I use 3 drawing programs and that I'm really enjoying. Procreate is like a staple. Everybody's talking about that. It's like the iPad version of Photoshop. And I don't know. I really like it. It has a lot of brushes that I don't use. Here is my greeting card collection that I recently did. Let's see, which one do I like best? Hello Baby is cute. And I tried out a different pattern, color palette. I can't talk. But I have the same ability to do quite a lot of things as I do in Photoshop. And I find it a little bit easier to understand all the different functions because it's a lot more simple. So I actually have learned this better than Photoshop, I'd say, for doing stuff like effects and masking and things like that. Like I said, it also create all of my Instagram illustrations in here. I think it's just the process of being able to sketch all of my work first in one layer. Let's pick one. I like this one. So I have the different layers and I can hide. I can bring up. So I can sketch in pencil on my illustrations and then I just go over it and add the ink and color and little extras. Like now I've started adding sprinkles and stuff like that. So in testing out different things, I think it's great. Also, I just save so much more time. I don't have any time because I'm a mom. And I stay at home, work from home. You can hear him, he's hanging out with me right now. And this just saves me time because before I would sketch and ink and erase the eraser or the pencil marks, and then I would scan it in, and then I would color on the computer. And this, I just do everything here, and then I just send it to Instagram directly. So that's great. I don't know what else to say about Procreate. So that's Procreate, and I mainly use that for, like I said, illustrations that I create as if I'm doing it in Photoshop, meaning they are just regular JPEGs. They're a little bit more artistic, I guess, because I keep like the hand-drawn lines. It's as if I was drawing in pen, and I'm amazed that I like the, let's bring it. But here's a drawing. And the brush I like the best is for inking called Dry Ink. And I swear it looks exactly as my pen did when I was drawing on paper. So I really like that when I moved over to digital, that it looks pretty much exactly the same as before. So that makes me happy. What else can I show you? Here's one, what's in my bag that I recently created, and it printed beautifully. So I'm really, really, really happy about that. And it was so much easier here too. When I get client changes, so easy to just go in and erase and stuff like that, instead of having to redraw, rescan, you know, stuff like that. Workflow. Whoops. Let's go into the next app that I use a lot. I'm going to start with another that's like the same as Procreate, but Adobe Sketch. This is a free drawing app, and I think that it's getting better and better as they update it. I'm still waiting for them to have a function where you can color fill, because that's how I create my illustrations. I draw the lines and then I fill with color. In this app, they don't have that function yet, so I'm just using it as it states for sketching out ideas, or if I'm just going to use sketch, like here I started drawing some artichokes. So if I'm just going to be using the pencil sketches, then I can use this app. And I also, one thing that I like about this is because it is in the same series as Adobe Illustrator and the Adobe Draw app. That's the vector app that they have, so you can create color palettes that you can use in both programs, so then you don't have to create color palettes for both, they just come up. Like I've been working on a new collection with a very muted, dirty pink kind of color palette, and I've been sketching out ideas. I usually don't do this, but I think that it's a good new thing that I want to test out to get my ideas down on paper and visualize it before I start drawing. And then I can see how the little mini collection is looking before I continue further. So here I can test out the color palette that I had chosen and my ideas, and then I can move into another, I can take another, do my pencil sketches later in this app, and then I will move everything over to Adobe Draw finally. Before I do that, maybe I can show you another one that I've been working on. This is another muted palette, and I really want to do. I was inspired the other day when I took a walk, and it was beautifully icy out on the lake here where I live. And then there was this swan sitting on top of this little stone out in the, by the water. It was really pretty. So I wanted to create that. All right. And then the last app that I wanted to show you is Adobe Draw. And this is a vector app. So this is what I use if I want to continue into Illustrator later to create a pattern. Like, you might recognize these ibis birds that I created recently. And yeah, I don't know. It's the process of coloring I find much simpler on the iPad in Adobe Draw than bringing it into Illustrator. And what's awesome is that you can, because it is an Adobe app, you just send it to Illustrator and it pops up on your screen if you have the CC version, which is magical and awesome. And I really like that. I don't know what else to say about that, but this is how I usually draw. Use that. So here's something. Like, I bring in a sketch that I did. That's not what I did. No, I need to bring in a better. Like, here, this is one of my recent patterns that I created, and I drew all the items in here. First, I brought in a sketch. There, I did a pencil sketch in Procreate, I think I did, instead of sketch. And it looks exactly like pencil. And then I bring it into Adobe Draw, and I draw over it to create the final illustrations. And then I send it over to the computer to finish the actual repeat pattern, because so far as I know, there isn't any app that you can create a finished pattern, and then none of these apps have that function yet. Okay, so, and then I would just like to quickly mention AstroPad. I use that to create like a mirrored effect with my computer, and this to make it like a Wacom tablet, a drawing tablet, so that when I'm working in Illustrator or Photoshop, I can easily use my Apple Pencil on the screen, and it's very easy for me to make little changes and things like that, so that's great. And I'm also obsessed with Amazio Graph. I think this is a great app to practice pattern making, and I'm coming up with lots of ideas that I might not have been able to think of in just my head, because I'm not very good at mirroring and stuff like that in my head or brain, you know. So this is a really amazing app that just, it's like kaleidoscopes and things like that, and it's fun to come up with new ideas and then kind of transfer them later into the computer. Alright, so I think that is just the rundown of how I am using the iPad so far, and I've only been using it for a couple of months, and I'm sure that I will figure out more stuff soon to better my workflow and new apps and stuff like that. If you have any recommendations for apps, I'd love to hear that, of course. What else? Well, before I forget, another feature that I really love about the iPad is that you can split the screen. So when I am drawing something, I can then bring up Pinterest as well. Let's see. So I go like this. You can split your screen like this. So I can bring up Pinterest at the same time, and I can sketch, I can look up reference images of a flower or whatever I'm drawing, and I can draw at the same time. So that's really neat and helpful as well. Okay, I think that's all I wanted to share. So, as you can hear, I am 100% pleased with the iPad Pro for digital drawing. For me, the way that I create art and patterns and illustrations and sketches and all that stuff, and I feel like it's kind of, I don't want to say like changed my life, but it has kind of changed my designing life, because it is so easy and it is so paperless. I love that. There's not mess. it easily like transfer to the computer and I can continue working and create the final files and but I can also pretty much do everything on it and I love that. I also love the AstroPad function that I can connect it easily to my large iMac when I want to maybe like finish a pattern in Illustrator and something like that. So that's also excellent. I think it's really helped my workflow and productivity, and I'm so excited for this year when I get to use it all the time and create lots of new work and patterns and stuff like that. So thanks so much for watching my video. I hope that you liked it, and I hope that you will continue to enjoy my content in the coming year. I hope that I can create more for you guys, so let me know what you'd like to see. And I didn't like food.